ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ఆల్ మైటీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ టుడేస్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 23 ఆఫ్ 5th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ శక్నోతి హైవయ సోఢం ప్రాక్ శరీర విమోక్షణాత్ కామ క్రోధోద్భవం వేగం సయుక్త సుఖీ నరః. ఇఫ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ద క్వశ్చన్, వి లివ్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు సాటిస్ఫై అవర్ సెల్ఫ్, ఈజ్ ఇట్ ట్రూ ఆర్ నాట్? ఆర్ డూ వి లివ్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు సాటిస్ఫై అదర్స్, ఆర్ బోత్? You people may say that, yes, actually, you know, so I would like to satisfy myself and I also would like to satisfy my people. Now, in order to satisfy myself, I need not to sacrifice anything. But in order to satisfy my people, I have to sacrifice certain things. Sometimes I have to satisfy with interest. Sometimes I have to satisfy without the interest in it. So this is the life. The conclusion is, we have to satisfy ourselves or our people. That is the life motto. In order to satisfy, we depend on the outside world. But Shastra says that is wrong. When you want to satisfy yourself, you need not to depend on the world. But when you want to satisfy others, even you need not to depend on the world. Is it confusing or not? A little bit. But if you think properly, you will just come out of the false impression about the satisfaction. Bhagavan Krishna is a very big psychiatric and also who is the very intelligent enough to present the content matter which are very much required, which is also in the form of clarity for the human being. The Krishna says, you cannot satisfy yourself when you depend the outsources. And you have to be very careful with yourself, the self which involves a physical system. The body has got its own nature, the world has got its own nature. And the conjunction of both, they create some kind of chemical reaction. Those reactions we call it experiences. Sometimes we love to have those experiences. And sometimes we don't love to have that experience. Now, completely life is nothing but our experience. So I am satisfying myself is also is kind of experience. And also, you know, if I want to satisfy others, if I am satisfying my father, mother and other people, then also I have to satisfy within me. Yes, I have to satisfy them. So this life, we are not saying that you should not work for your family. You have to work for your family. You have to work for the nation. You have to work for entire universe. All the creature must be respected, responded, and with responsibility we have to become responsible people for all the creatures. But Bhagavan Krishna says, need not to lose yourself when you want to work for others. Don't work with inadequacy, incompleteness. Work with completeness, adequacy. So when you are adequate one, you can produce the karma which are filled with adequation. So that's what the point you may not understand. You know, when you work for happiness, work with happiness, both are entirely different. Working with happiness, will it be possible? Because who taught us we have to work for happiness? Is it a self-conclusion or conclusion made by the society? So I am working for the satisfaction, I am working for the happiness. So working for happiness is a wrong dimensional action. We have to be very clear about this understanding. The sukham have been divided into two by the shastra, the happiness. So which is limited happiness called vishaya sukham. Why it is known as limited? Because time-wise, space-wise, they are limited. Any happiness you enjoy with your body, mind and sense complex, they are limited. And if you want to enjoy certain experience, eating mango, this eating mango you cannot enjoy throughout the year. Because the season has to be there. If there is no season, so nowadays, you know, without mango also there is a mango flavor. But whatever it is, original mango is the mango. If you want to enjoy the mango, you have to wait for that season to come. So everything, it has got a beginning and it has also got an ending. Now when mangoes are available, you should have the proper health to eat them, consume them. If you are with poor health, if you are, so by God's grace, we have to be healthy enough in our life. But if somebody is affected by sugar complaint, they cannot eat the mango. The mango is available, but these people don't have the position or condition to consume it. That is what a human life is. The human life, when the things are ready, you are not ready. When you are ready, the things are not there. It goes on and on like that. When things are ready and you are also ready, when you have the enjoyment, something pops from outside, the environment which is not suitable. So this is the condition of our human life. So satisfying is a game. It's a game, don't be victimized. It's a game between not you and the world, the game between your indriyas and the world, which is in the form of five aspects, you know, five tanmatras. So these tanmatras, which are known as rupa, rasa, gandha, sparsha, and these tanmatras, the touching sense, you know, sound, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. So these five aspects are penetrating, they are waiting to penetrate in you, not in you with your indriyas. They only contact indriyas and some kind of chemical reactions by which we are satisfied. That is wrong. Bhagavan Krishna says, your happiness is not there. Just you realize yourself, that is the sadhana. When you want to get unlimited happiness, which is explained in the verse number 21, which is also known as a Brahma Sukham, Brahmanandam. That is the happiness of the human being, the completeness. Brahma Sukham means you don't imagine that I should go up like, you know, it is a Paravasa state. Paravasa means the state which is not in your hand. Brahma Sukham means you are aware completely about yourself with awareness. And sadhana for that Brahma Sukham is to train your mind to get deviated or to take it away from this conjunction. Don't value it. That's what I said in the last class. We only value this connection. Otherwise, they don't disturb us. So that is the motto. So when you want to get unlimited happiness, you should get away from the attitude being enthused for limited happiness. Because our conclusion is, this life is to enjoy, this body is given to enjoy the life. But Bhagavan Krishna says, the body is to get a complete enjoyment, paripurna ananda. So this complete enjoyment is our motto, not with this childish game. A child may think by playing with the toy may get the happiness. But we are also doing the same. That has to be changed. Now, in these words, he says, this prak sharira vimokshanath, before death, you have to prepare yourself to gain the complete happiness. It means the complete dimension. The understanding about the body changes, understanding about the life changes. So now you may have the perception, the world is place for enjoyment, my body is the place for enjoyment, I have to enjoy the world. No, I have to be a joyful person, I have to enjoy the world means you make yourself as the hunter for the happiness. When you make yourself as the hunter for happiness, you should keep on hunting the happiness. It means what? The longing continues, the urge continues, this longing and urge, and they are the force, driving force for all the action means you are considered not hunter, you are considered as the slave. Do you want to continue your life as the slave? It doesn't look nice when you hear this. Then what kind of life is described here? The life with completeness, the life with endowed with complete happiness, the life which is filled with satisfactions. That kind of life is nothing but our motto. Therefore he says, before death you just prepare yourself. This body is given to conquer your karma and krodha. Throughout Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna again and again says, you have to master your karma and krodha. Kama yesha krodha yeshaha rajoguna samudbhavaha mahashano maha papma vidhena mikha vairinam. We want to correct the society. We want to correct our family. We want to correct our actions. But he, Bhagavan Krishna says, you have to correct yourself. For that alone the body is given, society is given, the entire world is created for you to prepare you for complete happiness. What kind of prepare I have to get it done? This body, we consider the place for happiness, but Krishna says, this body is given in order to make yourself free from anger and desire. Because these indriyas, they don't have kama krodha. And the world doesn't have the kama krodha. You alone are born with kama krodha. Use this body to make yourself correct, to make yourself adequate. By making yourself adequate one, then alone you can get rid of kama krodha. Otherwise, we will be smashing so many bodies. Innumerable bodies, shariras. We make one sharira, now we have got the sharira. We just demolish this, destruct this sharira with kama and krodha. This body, we have to have the pity on them. We are utilizing, victimizing this sharira for the sake of the desire, anger which we have. Ragadveshas. Kama means ragadvesha, likes and dislikes. Anger means the unfulfilled raga, and the without fulfilling, where there is a raga, it is converted as a krodha. Now I am victimizing this body, mind and sense complex for my raga and krodha. That is the perception one should have. But I have to use the same sharira to make myself pure and to make myself free from kama and krodha. So then you are considered as an intelligent soul who used this sharira, who used this world to get rid of kama and krodha. Then the self-satisfaction will come. Because this kama krodha which exist in our subtle body, they are the driving force to get more birth and death. Just you may correct, we have to use our body for that. And how to make it correct means you have to be a perceiver, as a seer. You have to be endowed with your real self, not with this body, mind and sense complex. When you identify with yourself means completely diverting your attention towards yourself, not towards Vishaya Sukha. Therefore, in the last words he says that you have to divert yourself, this Vishaya Sukha. If you think there is some Sukha, there is some Ananda, that's all. You will be pulled for thousands of Janmas. The world cannot satisfy me. That is the big conclusion one should have. The world doesn't have what I need. The world doesn't have what I need. It doesn't have, it don't have. That has to be the conclusion. But I'm not asking you to become a hater for the world. The world is nothing but Brahman, but our expectation is myth. We expect wrongly. When we expect wrongly, the world cannot do anything. It means what? We are the destroyer of ourselves and we destroy others' environment also. The conclusion about our own self, yaha prak sharira vimokshanat kama krodha udbhavam vegam shaknoti. The person, one who is withstanding with the force which are born out of kama and krodha, the force which comes, you know, as the desire, as the urge for something, to long for something. This longing is not from indriya. The longing is not from the vishayas. The longing exists within us. That longing, when it comes, you have to bear with that. You have to bear with means, you have to master with that. Because it has got beginning and end. So once it comes out, you just be witness and it will go down. If you feed them, it's like Agni, it will flourish like anything. So when you put ghee into the fire, the fire flames, it is nourished again. Therefore, don't satisfy that urge. That urge is a fake urge. Therefore, I said, you think that this birth is to satisfy me, you can satisfy only me by rejecting, by managing the force for desire to have something from outside. The urge has to be satisfied. You have to know how to balance you. For that, you need not to depend on the world. For example, you know, if you wish that my life is to enjoy, nothing wrong in that. So that enjoyment is not lying outside. And people say that if I'm not satisfying my mind, I won't be healthy person. Who said you are the satisfaction? You need not to depend on something else than you. Because when you realize about yourself, that is nothing but the happiness. So sayuktaha sa sukhi naraha, that's what the conclusion about the shastra. The happiness is not outside. The happiness which it seems to be coming from the outside contact, those happiness or fake happiness, finally they end with lots of struggle, lots of sadness, and finally you are left with dissatisfaction. You have to use this world, you have to use this body in order to get purified from kama and krodha. I can also say other word, we have to be free from kama and krodha. That is the only one solution. Not victimizing the world, not victimizing even our family. You know, one should not victimize his own body, mind and sense complex for his kama and krodha. Then what about the family members? We have to do or follow the duties what to be done. A father must do whatever to be done to his children, but not victimizing them for his kama and krodha. In the same way, we have to contribute to the society, not victimizing society for our kama and krodha. When we victimize others, we won't get complete happiness. That is the teaching from Bhagavan Krishna. You have to think a little bit. So when you think, you can realize the formula by which Krishna gives as the secret of the inner secrets, inner systems. Okay, the next words. Yontas sukhontara ramaha tathantar jyotirevayaha sayogi brahma nirvanam brahma bhutodhigachati. Now Krishna is talking about the person who is self-contented and who could find the joy in him, within him. So he talks about him, and he is not talking about the person who is hanging outside sources for his satisfaction. So now the person who is not depending to be happy for his own body and mind and sense complex. Yo antas sukaha, the person who is happy within himself, and antar aramaha, and who also rest in peace within himself. Tathantar jyotirevayaha, who could feel the illumined state inside. Sa yogi brahma nirvanam brahma bhutodhigachati, that person is considered as the yogi. Now yogi means it is not that imagining something. Yogi means who lives with complete awareness. He is aware about his body, mind and sense complex, and he is aware about the environment outside. He is completely aware about the nature of the nature, and he is also thorough with his own clarity about enjoyments. Saha brahma bhutaha adhigacchati, he becomes one with Brahman. He becomes Brahman alone. Next words. Labhante brahma nirvanam ruthayah kshina kalmashah chinnadvaidhayatatmanah sarvabhutahiteratah. He uses a new word, brahma nirvanam. Brahma nirvana means completely liberated state. A person who is completely liberated one, who is free from all kinds of bad deeds. Kshina kalmasha. Kalmasha means papas. So he is completely free from all papas. Those people are known as rishayaha, rishis, chinna dvaidaha. So this dvaidaha means doubts. They are free from all kinds of doubt. Doubts about life, doubts about death, doubts about birth, doubts about God, doubt about everything, no doubt, very clear. You know, when there are doubts, your life is filled with fear, anger and imbalanced emotions. Now he is perfectly fit with all the emotion, yatatmanaha, and also he is very careful with his own indriyas, sarvabhuta hite rataha, and he can also work for the society. So once you are able to balance your all ability, all aspects like body, mind and sense complex, so once you are filled with joy, so whatever the action comes out of you, so they only will produce joyful moment and joyful enjoyment for others. Next words, kama krodha viyuktanam yatinam yata cetasam abhito brahma nirvanam vartate viditatmanam. Those people who are free from anger and desire, yatinam yata cetasam abhito brahma nirvanam vartate viditatmanam. They need not to worry about birth, they need not to worry about the death. While living itself, so a person who becomes completeness, he never worry about death, whether death comes or not. So they are not changed, they are completely endowed with the supreme potential consciousness. They need not worry for it, they don't even think about the death. For them, death is no matter. Bhagavan Krishna continues the topic, so he is going to conclude the fifth chapter. We will conclude in the next episode. See you tomorrow in the next session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.